In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a spatial join. Why would you want to use a spatial join? Maybe you, like in this example, you want to count the number of points in a polygon, whatever that polygon is. So in our case, we're looking at child care centers per zip codes in San Diego County. Maybe we wanted to count them per census tracts or child care centers per county, or we wanted to count disease cases per state, whatever it is, all those point features we can count and tally within our polygons. So let's take a look at how this works. So spatial join is its own tool. So you will have to search for tools. You'll search just for that spatial join tool. It'll be the first one that pops up. So we have, well, first let's go back. Our spatial join tool that we're looking at here shows us that the attributes, the spatial join tool itself is joining attributes from one feature to another based on the spatial relationship. So unlike our table joins where we're joining a column in the attribute non-spatial attribute table to a column in an attribute table, here we're joining based on geography or based on that spatial relationship. So the relationship we want to define is we want to count the number of points in polygons. So our target feature is going to be the polygon. So in our case, it's the zip codes. In this example, our join feature will be the points that we're joining. So in this example, again, the child care center. We can then set our data to save to our geodatabase. For this example, we'll keep all target features because we want to be able to symbolize zip codes that have no child care centers. And we'll just, you can go through and delete all of these things if you don't care, which might make sense to do in this example, which I'm actually going to do. So I'm going to pause. No, I'm not. We'll just roll with it. So if you just, we'll leave our intersect option as intersect for now. And we will wait patiently. And we'll see our example output is added. So this green layer has been added. So if we open up our attribute table, we'll see two things right up front. Here's our zip code data that we can sort by if we wanted to see a specific zip code. And two, this new field, this count field, join count field has been added. So this will give us all of the child care centers in each zip code. So let's just simplify what we're looking at. So we can say, okay, in zip code 91915, which is down here, there are 10. We can look at 91942, and there are 27. You can sort this join count table as you need to, and you can also use it, oops, as your symbology. So we can sort by the quantities. We can sort by that join count and come up with some classification. Let's clear out our selection. We can turn this off, and then you can just display your data that way. Some things to remember, this data, well, one, we should probably have a class for zero, but for simplifying it, this is a new shapefile. So this is entirely new, entirely independent of everything else. So we can save this and open a new blank map and just bring in our example output and still have access to that join count and everything on this attribute table. So we still could symbolize we could change our symbology as needed. So let's say we wanted to do graduated symbols based on the join count. We could add that in here if we wanted to. So this is completely independent. You should keep it with all your other data, but if you remove a layer or delete a layer or hide a layer, you still will be able to display it as needed. So that's why you would use a spatial join to count the number of points in polygons. If you have any other questions on this, just let me know.